Sitting here with me right now is the minister, Minister Slater Johnson. And a while ago, we just, I don't know what to say about what we just saw, but we saw the work of God come in this place as he ministered to the people. No music at all, but the music was inside of him, and we're just excited to finally have you sitting here with us. We want you to tell the people some of the things that's going on with you, Mr. Johnson.
Man, I feel like this is my moment. I've been laying under the radar for quite some time, and God has finally released me to be not only public with my worship, but to be authentic with my worship. And there's so many people out here who are doing it for the wrong reasons, and God has just lifted that burden off of me. I don't pop it for nobody but him. And ever since I've done that, he has just blessed me in so many ways. I'm actually coming out with a project real soon. You know I'll be here with you.
Amen.
So just be looking out for the Slater to worship.
Amen. Another thing, Brother Slater, who are some of the biggest people as far as people like Mama Zappa and others that are out there now that you kind of like look up to as far as having some of your style? You have a unique style, but some of the people that give you motivation.
Well, sir, I'm not only here to sing. I came here for my musical mentor. He doesn't even know it because I listen to him on YouTube. I watch his every move. And that is no other than the Dr. Marvin L. Sapp. He is the greatest in my eyes. Fred Hammond, I mean, real writers of the music, just real preachers. These aren't people who just sing. Their word is better than their song sometimes. And it's not just the music, it's the lifestyle behind it. And the things that they've been through, people don't even know about. I mean, like Dr. Marvin losing his faith. I mean, you don't ask for it if you can't handle what you gotta go through. And so many of us take this thing for granted, man.
Well, but real quickly, we also know that you are director of music. I know that personally. And we just want you to tell us something about your home church, your home pastor, and some of the great things that you're doing at your church.
Oh, man, who could not give God glory for the Grace Fellowship Worship Center, where my pastor is none other than the Reverend Dr. James E. Jones Jr. We get in every Sunday. We don't come if it ain't an assignment. We don't show up to sit there, play backgate with God. We know we serve a God that favors us, and we don't even deserve it. So there's so many good things happening at the Grace Fellowship Worship Center. I am, like you said, one of the ministers of music over there, and I'm here on the praise team, and we just make sure that it ain't just about the music, it's about the worship and the lifestyle behind it. A lot of people singing, but ain't nothing coming out.
Amen. But I'm going to tell you right now, we're live in Hampton, Virginia, at the Happy University Congregation Center. It gets no better than this. Marvin Sapp is coming tonight, but before Marvin came, we already had a blessing with this young man right here. The brother, the Reverend Slater Johnson, a young man that's out there doing something great in our community. We're live in Hampton, Virginia, where God is first and he's everything. God bless you. We'll be back soon. Amen.
Thank you so much.
life is good. Praise Him. Come on, every Sunday.
Janet.